Hello, everybody. Welcome to the podcast. Today, I'm going to have some wonderful guests. I'm very excited to meet them. I know most of them because most of them are my mom's students or my students. So yeah, let's find out what people have been cooking up for the projects that they will be presenting on Saturday and competing with for a prize for the final recital of the year. So let's jump into it. Okay, what is your project?
So I made a piece for the piano, and it's called Humoresque.
Humoresque?
Yeah.
Okay. Why did you call it that?
Because it made my mom laugh a lot, and I thought it was funny how that in violin I was playing Humoresque. Mm-hmm. In piano, I'm also playing Humoresque. So it'd be fun if after we say that I only played Humoresque. So yeah.
It's like, what piece are you playing? Humoresque asks the other teacher. The other teacher asks, what are you playing? Humoresque. I already said. Right, same, but yeah. Different instruments. Okay.
So I made it on Noteplate, and then I printed it out, and now I'm going to play on the piano.
Is it a composition, or?
Yes.
Okay. Well, how long have you been working on it?
So to make the actual piece, it took 4 hours.
Okay.
And then, then I realized how hard it was to play, so I had to tweak it a little to make it easier to play, and I'm still tweaking it, to be honest, and I've gotten pretty far in practicing it.
And what kind of style should we expect?
Dramatic,
sad, happy, exciting?
I guess it's happy.
Okay, cool. The project, like, why do you think people will vote for your project? What are you most excited about?
I honestly don't think I will win this time, but if anything, I think people would vote for me because of it's really original, and it's pretty enjoyable to hear, actually.
Okay. Hey, Harry. How are you doing? Harry, what's your project?
It's a piece I made.
Alright. Composed?
Yeah.
What kind of piece is it? What is it called? You know.
It's called a breakup sonata.
Why is it called that?
Since I broke my blue cup.
Oh, the blue cup. I remember about this. Okay. And, is it like sad, or is it like, is it about missing the cup? Is it about being very upset about the cup, or is it about like moving on from the cup?
It's very happy. It's something happy.
So it's like moving on from it, like being like, you know, letting go of the cup. Maybe something like that. Okay. Well, we'll hear it. How long you been working on it, and how long's the piece?
I started it since I broke it. So I started like 4 months ago.
Wow. Okay. That's a big project.
Violin and piano, by the way.
Okay. So you're playing both piano and violin?
No, my mom's playing violin. I mean piano. I'm playing violin.
Okay. Cool. Alright. How long is the piece?
1 minute.
The errand, but do I have to change? No. Raise
yeah,
video?
You have to get pretty.
No, it's okay. No, it's okay. It's okay.
I'm literally in my pajamas.
Yeah, pajamas. That's exactly what we want to see. Come on, the casual artist in their natural habitat. That's what we want to see. Hey, Aaron.
Hi.
How you doing? Oh, perfect. Cool. All right, how are you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Welcome to the super awesome and never seen before podcast run by me.
Yeah, episode one.
Episode one. Cool. So what's your project?
That's gonna be.
I'm composing a piece like my brothers, and it's for violin and piano. The violin is the melody, and the piano is the accompaniment.
Are you playing? Are you playing the both of the instruments? Are you? Is it gonna be a recording?
Yeah. So my musical theater teacher showed me this like app for the iPhone where you can just like add two videos together. Mm-hmm. So I can finish composing it for him. So yeah.
Okay, that's cool. So you're writing and then you're playing, right? Are you writing the actual score, or are you just doing? Okay, cool. How long is it gonna be? Like the piece?
Right now, I'm aiming for around 2-3 pages.
Okay. And is it like, you know, fast paced, or is it like a more slow? Is it melancholy?
It's rather fast. Yeah.
Like exciting, it's not... happy, or like, you know,
it's angry, more, it's frustrated. I don't know. It's more bouncy.
Okay, bouncy. All
right. Yeah.
What is it called again? Or did you, what is it going to be?
I did not title it.
Maybe I'm going to need a title when it comes to Saturday.
No, that's good. Piece for violin and piano. Done.
Okay. Is it your first time writing something?
No.
How many pieces or like things have you finished or done before, projects like this?
I have no idea actually, because they don't count. Like, I've done a composition for every single year and recital.
Okay.
And but then I've also like composed outside. Like, I used to compose when I was younger for my brother's birthday. So yeah.
Joel or Harry? Both of them?
Like, I composed a piece for Joel once, I think.
Okay. So yeah. How many times have you done, like, final recital compositions? How many
I
times?
I don't remember.
You don't remember? Okay.
I don't remember.
That's probably a lot more experience than most. So that's pretty cool. What are you excited about, like, people hearing it on Saturday?
I just want people to, like, enjoy it and just like, yeah. So like, my mom like actually helped me with this, because she had the like bowl, and then I had to pick out two notes in a rhythm. So that was basically like how I started, because I had another composition that I was gonna do, but it was just like not, it was too messy kind of. So I restarted and did this. So.
Okay. Cool. Interesting. All right. Thanks.
Yeah.
See you around. Are you in your pajamas right now, or you switched something?
No, I'm wearing pajamas.
Most artistic brain power usually comes when you're in the most comfortable clothes, in my opinion.
I am so tired, because I just want to deliver my graduation speech. So
you just did, or? Oh wow! You were doing a graduation speech? Like,
yeah.
How was that?
So we were halfway there, then I realized I didn't print it, so I think we had to go back and then.
Did you memorize it? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think anybody can memorize. It was like a page, so.
Was it double spaced?
No, it was.
Oh wow! Okay, so that's a lot of text. All right. Cool. Thanks for coming. Emily, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Cool. All right.
Do you need me, or I'll just let you talk to her?
It's up to you. However you guys feel comfortable doing this.
Do you want me to stay?
Yeah.
All right, I'll stay.
Okay, sure. All right, there we go. What is your project?
I'm doing a garage band.
Composition? What kind of style is it?
It's like kind of happy, but then it gets scary, if that makes sense. It just starts off happy, and then the scariness takes over, but then it ends happy again.
Scary as in like menacing or like more like powerful?
Powerful, I guess.
Okay. Like exciting, maybe?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. What inspired you to do this, do a composition?
I don't really know. I just like doing garage bands.
Okay. How long have you worked on the project?
Maybe like an hour and a half.
Okay. And like how long have you been using GarageBand, I guess? When's the first time you used it, maybe?
The first time, I think, was like a couple of months ago for school.
Okay. Oh, so it was a school project that got you into GarageBand?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. What kind of instrumentation are we looking at?
They're drums, violin, and like strings and guitar and electric guitar.
Wow. Are you, which ones, are you playing the violin part there? Are you yourself?
No, I didn't actually like physically play any of them, but on the iPad, I did some of the guitar, like on the screen.
Okay. Did you have any help from like your dad or your family or siblings?
Well, not like they didn't like do like actually like put the tracks on, but they did say like tips, I guess.
Okay. So you got some feedback from there as well.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Thanks guys for coming on.
Thank you. We're looking forward to it.
What's your project? Let's start with that.
My project is me playing the piano and violin. Okay. And then combining them together and then adding my singing to make it a complete three-roll project completely made by me. Well, a little help from Dad, what are you getting?
Okay, great. And I got to hear a little bit snippet because you guys sent me that. I really appreciate that. Oh, you didn't know? Oh, okay. Julian didn't know. Betrayal!
Hey, Mom. You're the ball lady.
Oh, I shouldn't have said anything. Oh, no. No, it was great. That was really cool.
You're violating.
We're trying to get some feedback, right? So make sure that when you're
right.
Going to your vocal recording.
You're violating my terms and policies and my privacy policy.
Agent, oh, really? Fired. No. No, but now you're going to have so much more feedback on Saturday. I mean, it's so close to the date. I don't think it's a big deal, right? Come on, you can let this one go. Well, what is this piece about, you know? Is it happy? Is it sad? You know, start with that. And then, like, what is maybe more about it?
Sweet, sad.
Bittersweet.
Okay. What do you imagine when you play it or when you were writing it? Where's your inspiration from?
It's a piece from the movie Spirited Away.
Yeah, it's actually the theme.
It's like a cover.
From the movie. Yeah, so it's a cover. Okay. So it's not like a new piece he composed.
Okay.
I'm not good enough.
Well, I mean, covers take a lot of work. You're not just copying the music, you're actually interpreting it in a lot of different ways, right? So that's pretty cool.
Small arrangement.
Arrangement.
Small adaptation. Make it simpler.
Okay.
Not make it simpler, exactly making it more complicated.
Oh, okay. I agree. Okay.
What was the most challenging part about it, do you think?
Coordination.
And what did you record first? What did you do after?
I recorded piano first because I thought it was the accompaniment so that I could use the melody with the accompaniment. From my experience of the recital.
Oh, your experience of the recital.
Okay, cool. Anything else you want to say about the piece?
No.
What? Why?
I think
what,
that
what makes. What? Huh?
I think
no, it's your piece, right? So I'm just, you know, my main job is...
What is the Simon Cowell's opinion here? Because the real Simon Cowell, I think, is
Eugene. Give critical comments continuously and consistently.
You look great, by the way. I like the shirt. What is this? What is on that shirt?
Airplane.
Airplanes. Yeah. Okay, cool. Spiriting Away, right? Airplanes. Have you composed before? Have you done covers before?
No.
This is your first time? Okay. You've composed before, no?
I've composed before, but I've never arranged and I've never did a cover before.
I think you did some arrangement for your school song, right? What that song? Right? You actually play that.
Yeah, you can see that I composed that.
Oh, you composed that. Oh, okay. So there we go.
Okay, great. Well, that means you got some experience behind you. That's good. Okay. That's all I got. Thanks, guys. Thanks okay. for coming. And good luck.
Thank you.
See you on Saturday.
Yeah, see you soon. Bye.
Bye. How are you guys doing? You guys excited for Saturday?
Nervous and excited.
Nervous and excited. Why are you nervous?
Well, I don't know why I should be. Usually when I'm nervous that makes me better, but I'm just nervous.
So it's like an adrenaline boost, right? Yeah. Okay, cool. And you know how to ride that. All right. What is your project?
It's a little poem.
Okay. It's a little bit bright. Okay, you don't have to show us the poem or anything, but what is it about?
It's just that music is kind of special compared to other things.
So is it about your love for music? Your family's love? Or?
If you make a wrong note, it doesn't destroy. Unlike, you know, a pen, if you mess up, then you have to restart.
Okay.
Philosophy, but it's his feeling about how music is.
Okay, cool. And maybe, what made you decide to do a poem?
Well, it's not the other things. I'm not really good at composition. The other things, I couldn't find a way to, like, put my love of music in there. So a poem would be the easiest way.
Okay.
It's interesting that he didn't want to rhyme. He wasn't trying to put rhyme and rhythm to it, so.
It's like prose more? Like prose poem kind of? Do you have a certain poets that inspire you to do poetry for this?
No, I just think it sounds good.
Okay. Any poets that you like out there?
Usually I don't even know the names.
Okay. Does Dad know anybody that he would read?
No, he doesn't have a favorite, but they start introducing poetry at about second grade.
Okay.
Well, they start earlier, of course, with songs and things. But,
yeah, because I would think, like, poetry usually is pretty, it doesn't automatically just happen to be literature laying around that you just read all the time. I think poetry is kind of more intentionally found a lot of the time.
Yeah. Well, so. I read him some, you know, from various collections.
Okay. Very cool, because I don't think I've seen anyone talk about anyone's doing poetry yet, at least from who's come up right now so far in the podcasts, I guess. So that's exciting. I'm looking forward to it. Anything else you want to add about it?
Not much. Just gonna put a few pictures in with the words to make it more exciting.
Okay, so you got some illustrations.
Yeah, he put in an unusual instrument or two. Is this an instrument?
It's a bass.
No, that's a... Okay, which... Tell me what instruments you have in there.
This is a drum. This is a thumb piano.
Uh-huh.
Thumb piano.
Okay.
Have you seen a thumb piano, Fedor?
I'm not sure. What is that? A thumb piano?
It's a little wooden square, and then there's a little, like, silver prongs, and then you pluck them like this.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, actually, you can see those. I think the reason I know about those is because they appear a lot in Kennedy Center gift shops. Have you seen those there? No, you never been to them? Yeah, you can get one of those. I think usually they have them there in the music stores. They like to do that. It's similar to, like, the ideas behind music boxes, right? Where you turn a thing and it plucks these metal also usually pieces, and it has like a set rhythm to it or whatever, and then it creates a kind of like a song.
This is our first round, first year with the studio, so this is the
congratulations.
And so we had to kind of pull it together last time.
Well,
really good job for being under pressure.
Yeah, I think you'll do great. I mean, if you put, seems like a lot of effort around it, because it's not, I mean, poetry, you could just write words, but you also have all illustration around it. So it's very personal, I think, for you. So I'm excited to see it. Yeah, X has been roaming around. around the table in 20 seconds.
So he's your dog?
Yeah.
Or he's the whole...
He's the family dog, really. Yeah. I mean, he started out being mine, and then, you know, with college and other things, like, sometimes my mom would take care of him more than me. So.
Yeah, they have a lot of need, so they'll take up all the adults if they can.
Yeah, but he's quite self-sufficient. He's very, very independent. He goes out on his own, he goes for runs on his own outdoors, and he asks to play fetch when he really needs to get the energy out and things like that. So, yeah. Cool. Thanks for coming, guys.
All right.
Well, hello, Floor Gang. How are you doing? Okay. All right. How are you guys doing?
Fine.
What's your project?
Oh, so I actually make a so-called piano.
Oh, wow. Oh, so that's your project? Using popsicles? Yes. Oh my God. Okay. How does it work?
It's not a finished product yet. We still haven't painted it yet.
But you play it like this.
Okay. Cool. How are you tuning the different keys, I guess?
Well, I just unscrew the screws and move in different positions. I use a tuning app.
Okay. And so you tune it to the tuning app, and then you decide how long it is, right? Because if it's shorter, then it'll be higher pitch. And are you going to play something on it?
Yes, in the recital? I'm just going to play a Twinkle Twinkle Little Star or something.
Okay, cool. And how did you come up with this idea?
Well, I was scrolling through YouTube.
Okay, cool. And did you find somebody else doing it too?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. How long did it take you to do that, make that?
Like 4 or 5 hours.
Okay, wow. Pretty impressive. Do you like to like look at different crafts and like quick things like that and cool stuff on YouTube? Is that like your passion? So you do that pretty often? Is that a regular thing?
No, this was just for my music project, actually.
Okay. How many keys are there on there?
I haven't
counted.
It's 29 keys.
29. Okay,
29. No, sorry. It's
33
keys.
Okay. Cool. Are you going to be playing live, or are you going to record something and then show it on Saturday? You're playing live on Saturday. Okay, cool. All right, that's pretty unique. Pretty unique project. Yeah, I like to look at like cool projects like that on YouTube as well. I think that's really cool stuff out there. And it takes a lot of time and work, so I'm excited that you put in so much effort into this. So I hope people will vote for you on Saturday.
Thanks.
How about your dad? How much did your dad help with this? What was your dad's role in this?
Well, he screwed a little bit. He put in the screws.
Okay.
I was the one. I tuned it.
Okay. Cool. All right. Thanks guys for coming. Bye. Take care.
Remember to subscribe and leave a comment down below.
Thanks for doing my job for me.
Break. 5 stars. 5 stars.
5 stars, please.
That like button.
All right.
Check out other videos down below.
Yeah, down below. Click the notification bell. Uh-huh. All right. See ya.
Bye.
Thanks for the outro.
Bye.